Okay, I think we have a lot of questions, but first, Mazam entrepreneur, how does it feel?
Oh, thank you.
I mean, it's a completely new label, actor, we've seen. Now entrepreneur, it's heavy? You feel heavy? Is this a heavy label?
Oh, I'm excited. First of all, thank you so much, everyone, for being here with us today. And thank you so much, Kusha, for coming here today. I'm so happy that you could be here.
I'm so happy to be a part of this campaign, this entire brand. But I have to ask you, Katrina, how was it? Like, how are you as an entrepreneur?
Well, I don't know, but I mean, I'm learning from the best. I mean, honestly, I've got Falguni right here with me. And can I just say that, I mean, since I've always had a dream of launching my own beauty brand. It's been a dream of mine, which it just seemed like such a huge task. And, you know, makeup right from the time I started as a model in my career to obviously, you know, my whole journey as an actor, it's such an important part of our everyday life. And I really wanted to create a product which would be long-lasting, extremely glamorous, but also care for your skin. Because to me, I mean, these things, it's all in the details, you know? You really want something that you know is actually good for your skin when you put it on. Yeah. And it just seemed like a lot to do. And when I found my partners with Falguni and Veena, who's going to be joining us shortly with Nykaa, it was kind of like love at first sight from the first meeting because I saw someone who shared my passion.
Yeah.
Now, I can be really, really hard on myself. And as hard as I am and how much I demand from myself, I also wanted that from the products and from, you know, the brand we were going to build together. And I saw that same passion in both Falguni and Veena. And without their team, without the way that their whole team has worked tirelessly, endless hours, and I mean that, endless hours, for two years, I think, we've been creating this. Countless meetings, endless cups of coffee. These meetings in my house where the table just would look like, I mean, it would be covered in beauty products with samples and everything. And it was teamwork. And finally, here we are today at the launch of K-Beauty. And I couldn't be happier, and I'm extremely excited.
So is it everything you'd imagined?
It's everything and more. It's so much fun. It's my dream. I mean, for me, I am a makeup girl. You know, like there are some girls who are into handbags, there are some girls who are into other things, but for me, it has been makeup, and I know makeup. I do makeup, so it's I know products. You know, like when me and Rina, who's, you know, she develops all the products, we would just sit and play. It was just like it was instantaneous. We would know what we wanted. We know what we liked. And I don't think we can have a better, you know, leader in terms of business and knowing the consumer than Falguni. And what's great for me is what I learned from Falguni is she's so precise with her decisions, you know? There's no uncertainty or, you know, hemming and hawing. She's clear. She knows where she's going, what she wants. And it's great because I feel like that we're all a team and we're on this exciting journey together, and it's just starting.
And I feel like the thing you say about Falguni, I think that's why she's the boss, because she's like quick, she's very decisive. But we're speaking about Rina, right? So now it's time for the other key Nykaa woman in the partnership today, who's Rina Chhabra, CEO Nykaa Brands. With over 20 years of experience in the beauty industry, she's one woman show when it comes to creating beauty brands, from identifying trends, picking innovative formulations, designing packaging, and directing production to sales. She's really done it all. Please welcome on stage Rina Chhabra.
No.
Hi.
So, Rina, I have a question straight up. So Katrina mentioned how she's worked very closely with you on K-Brands. How is she to work with? I think everybody wants to know.
Do we have time for that?
I would say that she drove us very hard. But in the end, I think we're so happy.
I think she drove us very hard in trying to find the right colors, the right formulation, what she wanted, what she didn't. The whole industry's heard how exacting she is. At the end, I think I can only say that we're very happy because the products have come out so well.
Yeah.
I think they're a formulation that you haven't seen. The colors are unique. They're as long lasting. And you know, they had to go through the rigor of all her shoots and last at the end of the shoot. So we are excited to launch this.
So what's the journey been like for you? Like the entire K-beauty journey, if you had to like quickly tell everybody in the room.
I think it's been very unique because, of course, as all people, you know, we were in awe of Katrina Kaif, the actress. What we did not realize is how knowledgeable she is about makeup and how hardworking she is and how she's put her heart and soul into the makeup. And thankfully, you know, because of that, she's also allowed us to carry the K logo on the product. So very happy that Katrina gets her own monogram. And it's a lovely luxe offering that we've been able to make.
Katrina, give us a little insight into K-beauty. Why is it called K-beauty? I think everybody's curious in the room, right?
Well, we wanted something that had that resonated with my name, which is, you know, Katrina. And we didn't want to have, somehow it just wasn't, we weren't like feeling that just, you know, because a lot of people do put their names when they start something and they put their whole name. And it just kind of happened one day. And I think we just all unanimously felt that moment where we were like, yes, this is right. It just, I felt it was easy. You know, it's kind of, you know, you get it, K, Katrina. And it just, it was a name which to me seemed really smooth.
Yeah.
And everyone loved it. Rina loved it. Falguni loved it. So we thought about it. And then we were like, yeah, this is sticking. And it just felt right.
It was the organic, obvious choice.
It was the organic, obvious choice. Yeah. But you know, I mean, right from the beginning, the first meeting, I'll never forget where Falguni and Rina came, and I have a fairly small table, dining table. And the first meeting, it was very neat. And then gradually, as our meetings would progress, as we were into sample stages, choosing product, choosing packaging, and the whole Nykaa team, they have an office full of incredible girls. And that's, you know, all I need is their feedback. They used to come, and we would have these big makeup sessions where they would come with nice, you know, clean faces. Mm-hmm. And when they would leave my house, someone would have a blue eye, someone would have a brown eye, someone would have a red lip. Poor Falguni's daughter used to really be the guinea pig with me. She would have one type of foundation here, another type here, contour here. And they would be all with these big smiles because we are so excited. But it's been exactly that. It's been a dream creating this brand. And the wonderful thing is that Rina really understands exactly when I say that, listen, I don't like this texture, or I want this kind of texture, I want this kind of, you know, consistency. You know, she goes out there and she doesn't stop until she finds it.
Yeah. But, you know, before I go on further, guys, we have to acknowledge the stage. I mean, three incredible women on stage giving you the best of beauty. I think we need an applause for that. Come on.
Thank you.
Okay, next, I have something really exciting to introduce. It's a personal story before, anecdote. So, you know, one day I get a message, random message saying, hi, will you please call me back, Katrina Kaif? And I was like, what? Like, how many times in your life can you say you get a message from Katrina Kaif? And I was like, is somebody playing a prank on me? But she insists on getting on a call. And I think then for about like half an hour, we speak about your vision. I could really see her sincerity, her commitment to the brand, and how incredibly into she was, you know, in the whole what she wanted to bring out for people. And I was like, Katrina Kaif, the actor, is so consumed into what she wants to bring out to the world. And I was like, yes, I want to be a part of this campaign. And she's like, you know what, Zoya Akhtar is writing the movie, the film that we are going to show.
It's almost like a movie, though.
it
was that
movie.
Much work that it felt like this ad film was like a movie production.
But Katrina's information, Katrina's interest, and Katrina's involvement in the project really made me want to be a part of it. And she said she was working with Zoya Akhtar to create a film that would tell the story of this brand. Katrina, would you like to tell us about the film?
So the film, because that's what it's like, has been, it's been as much work as any, like, making a movie. So it kind of all started one Sunday. So the idea, I kind of knew what I wanted to say and what we wanted to say with K-Beauty. We wanted to speak to women. We didn't want to talk at women and tell them what we thought. We wanted to speak with them and to them. And there was a lot of discussion between us that, you know, should we go this direction for our first campaign or this direction? one Sunday after, you know, cups of coffee with Zoya and me and my girlfriends and all of us, and we were discussing this. We came up, Zoya said, let me just write something based on the conversations we've had between me and her, because, you know, we meet almost every Sunday for like a girl's lunch. And let me just, you know, come up with something about everything I've heard you say, that I heard, you know, us say about women and about makeup and about, you know, how we feel about the brand. And one Sunday, we called up Falguni and Reena, and we went to Zoya's house on a Sunday, pulled Falguni out of her out of her house, and we went there, and Zoya read it out, and Falguni was like, this is it. I loved it, because, you know, we worked on it together, and it was, this is exactly what I want to say with K-Beauty. And after that, honestly, the team of women who I got together for this film,
yeah.
I can't tell you how grateful I am, because they're just such, everyone is incredible. I mean, as Kusha said, she's been so gracious to be a part of the film. To everyone else who's in the film, I want you to see the film first, but I mean, I can say it before as well. The Raja Kumari has done the voiceover for us, which just gives it that life, and yeah. So many incredible other women, which we can talk about after you see the film. What I really wanted it to be about was to showcase women from different professions who have different achievements, and through their grit and determination have succeeded in their chosen profession. And also women who celebrate different kinds of looks and different kinds of beauty. And every person who's in the ad is someone who I personally love and admire. And really, really happy with it. It was a tough journey. I'm incredibly grateful to Zoya Akhtar too, who's written it for us, and she worked on it with me like it was her own baby, and Anita Shroff, who did the entire styling. It was like some 37 outfits,
yes.
and we had like a weekend to do it. And she worked on it again, literally like it was her own brand. I mean, she took as much stress as I did. She was running up and down, helter skelter, and both of these women, I think, were all of us really grateful that they just, you know, supported us like this. And can't wait for you to see it now.
Yes, yes. And before I introduce this film to you, I have to tell you that whatever you see in this film, it is not directed. Nobody's been told what to do. Literally, the brief was, be yourself, get your vibe in, do whatever you want to do. And everything that you see is what people, their own personalities, their own energies into it. So I'm very proud to introduce the film, hashtag It's K to Be You, written by Zoya Akhtar.
Yeah, I think you have to play it once or twice more to get all the lines, because the lines are incredible. Should we ask everyone to play it once more?
Not just the lines, all the shots. I feel like the rushes. And what I will suggest when you actually watch the movie on Instagram, just like download it and watch it like at lesser speed, like slow it down, and you'll really enjoy it. But let's please watch it again.
It's all due to Instagram. They should start allowing 2-minute videos.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely lovely. That was the voice of Raja Kumari, guys. The words of Zoya Akhtar and the message of Katrina Kaif and K-Beauty. Thank you, Katrina, Falguni, and Reena, for joining us. We're happy to take some questions now. So, open for you all.
Hi.
A mic is, yeah.
We can hear you. You have a strong voice.
Hi, congratulations. This is Sohail here. Congratulations to the entire team and Katrina. Since a very long time, you've been working on this, like, you know, what was the thought process like that came first in your mind to go into beauty products?
So I think right from probably maybe 3-4 years back, I've always had this thought and this dream more than anything to start a beauty brand. And right from the time that I started as a model, makeup has always been something which I've understood and that I've played with a lot and that I experimented with a lot. And it just seemed like this was something, a natural progression that I really wanted to do. For this to be possible, I needed to find partners who had all the information and who had that, you know, the wherewithal to make it happen. So once I found that with Falguni and Reena, we went full steam ahead into putting this, you know, into production. And it's been exactly that. It's been 2 years of really passion, work, hard work, determination to put this brand into finally now being live today in the stores.
Can I add to that? So, you know, when we started meeting Katrina, I think some of the things that she really looked out for, very, very high performance products, because she felt that makeup didn't last through her shoes, so it had to be long lasting. The second thing she was very particular about is that the product should be good for her. So every product has ceramide, marula oil, etc. So even if you wear it, you can feel good about wearing it. I think those were the two aspects of the brief that she gave us.
You have been dreaming since the last 2 years, so you must have definitely, you know, consulted your colleagues also. Did you ask anything to Salman Khan about the dream also?
I think makeup is one area where I don't need to ask any of my wonderful male colleagues for too many tips, but I was happy to give them. I don't know if you got a chance to see my video with Ranveer that we did the other day. So, I mean, you know, it's guys look great with some kajal, and, you know, everyone sometimes maybe can use a bit of concealer here. he's thinking about it in the front. He's like, But everyone's been incredibly supportive, and honestly, the response from the morning to the film, that everyone in the industry has just kind of showed their support for this brand. It's a big endeavor, and it's a big thing for me, and I'm really just happy the way everyone's really shown their love and support.
Yeah. Let's take the next question.
Hi, Katrina. Hi, Kusha. Of course, Falguni and Reema. I mean, I'm so excited to be here. I'm Sachi Basin Daga from Calcutta. And my question is, of course, to Falguni ma'am. First of all, I mean, I'm so excited to see this collaboration and see a brand by none other than Katrina Kaif. I mean, if we can look even a little bit like her, we are buying everything. So I just wanted to know that what made you actually launch like the first celebrity beauty brand and actually collaborate with Katrina and, you know, the whole process? How did you really make this happen?
I think we have to admit that it was Katrina. Like she said, she was thinking about doing a beauty brand and she reached out to us. And we love the idea. We actually, it's a partnership and we own the brand jointly. And the hardest thing about partnership is to be on the same page. So there was a lot of meeting of minds in all directions, not just from product partnership that Katrina and Reena shared to business partnership that Katrina and I shared. I think it's been a true partnership, even to agree on names or to agree on a marketing campaign. It's none of that is easy. So I think what I'm really proud of is that there is a true partnership here and it's really allowed us to bring a very unique, and like I said earlier, we've experimented and we've brought really innovative products to the market and we believe in them. We've not tried to benchmark, oh, this brand is here, let's do that. It's a very original brand coming from Katrina's experiences and our team has worked very hard to bring that together.
Lovely, thank you so much.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Geeta Rao from Geeta's List and my question is to Reena actually, although anyone can answer it. We love the first look and I just love the way it's all unfolded. But the question is, when do we expect the next drop from K-Beauty?
I think, of course, we would like, this is India's first celebrity brand, so none to say that, of course, you will see a full line of 1,000 SKUs across all categories. So hopefully next month.
Ooh, woo. Yes, yeah, you in the back. The one in white, ma'am. Yes, you. Can we please have the mic there? Or do you just want to ask your question? We'll try hearing it.
I'll speak it out for you.
Yeah, it works. It works. That works. Yes.
Shade that I can wear every day. Which one do you recommend to all the college girls? That's a good question. I actually would say the one that I wore to the Vogue Awards the other night. I know it sounds like it's a big award, so is that right? But actually, I really, really love kind of lip colors that are also kind of just in the nude family. And this was one called Billboard. And it just kind of matches and it just blends into your skin. So it gives you just that hint of like of a glow, a little bit of a sheen, but it's not too maybe in, you know, upfront for everyday college going. Beautiful girl like yourself.
So Billboard it is, guys. Take notes. Let's take the next question. Thank you for your question. Yes, sir in the back, yes. Mic de de one, please.
Hello. Hello?
Yes.
Hi, Katrina.
Hello.
Hi, Katrina.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm very good. How
Looking
are you?
Fabulous as always.
Thank you.
Katrina, the new beauty mantra is less is more. So what's your experience and what is the reason when this is the understated fashion statement is new styling and beauty mantra? So in this scenario, launching and coming out with this makeup brand, so what's the whole journey and what was the reason behind this?
You know, there's a few things that we wanted to do with K-Beauty. One is that I do believe that everyone is most beautiful when they're most themselves and when they're most happiest in their own skin. So you never want, I never want makeup to look like it's overpowering you or that it's sitting on your face. It should blend into your skin. It should care for your skin. The other thing, which is also extremely important, which I think everyone here can agree with, is time. All of us are short on time. Sometimes you're getting up in the morning, you're late for work, you're late for a meeting. You just want a few key products which can just, you know, give you that little extra glow, give your face, your features, that little pop. And that's really where we came up with Makeup on the Go. And Makeup on the Go is what this first collection that we've launched is all about, which are just the key products that even if you just have these key products, you can really, you know, you can really highlight and enhance your features. And that's what this first product launch is all about. As Veena said, we have a very extensive line planned, and that rollout is going to be really exciting.
Thank you, Katrina. Hi, we'll just take the last question, sir.
Yeah, hi. Yes. One question
in
from
the
this
back.
Side. Kat. Hi, Katrina. Yeah, मेरा प्रश्न ये है कि beauty products बहुत होते हैं, but लोगों को लगता है कि beauty products इतना मतलब लगाना ठीक नहीं है. But how beauty products make anyone beautiful और कितना उनके personal जो confidence है उसको कितना बढ़ाते हैं, कितना वो जरूरी है beauty को enhance करने में.
You know, I think what you said, ma'am, is exactly what this the ad film which we've made is all about. That beauty does not come from makeup. That I could not agree with you more. Makeup is here. Makeup is for us to enhance and to highlight the beauty that's already there in every woman and the beauty that's already there in all of us. And I really, really believe that. I mean, every woman is beautiful and unique in her own way. And you have to celebrate that. And when you celebrate that and you're comfortable in your own skin, that's when you really are beautiful. And then you just have fun with makeup. You know, makeup is to, you play with your moods. You just, you highlight the features which you love. You use it as to enhance the person you already are.
Hi, Katrina. Sakshi this side from E24. My question to you is, Diet Sapya recently accused one of your campaign photos to be copied from KKW beauty brand. What do you have to say about that? Thank you.
Yeah, you know, today is about makeup and it's about a launch which all of us have worked incredibly hard on. So let's leave it about that. But everything and every collaborator on this brand, K-Beauty, right from the products to every creative collaborator is entirely original. Thank you.
And let's just end this with when I... Okay, guys, this is the end of our session. Let's just end this with... Let's just end this with, when I first spoke to Katrina, she told me that she does a lot of her makeup on her own. So this comes out of pure passion. This comes out of pure love for makeup. So let's end this session now. Thank you everyone for being a part of the K-Beauty launch. Okay.
Sorry.
time.
Have a good
next question is next press conference. We need someone for that.